And you're basically making it. You're basically making a square with the block tool. So right here, it tells you that you have to move forward.
Okay, you gotta slow down, because I'm an old man.
So right, right here.
So what's going on here?
You're making a block.
I'm gonna make a block.
I'm in a square.
A square. Okay.
You're gonna make a square with the code block.
Okay.
And you have five right here, which is already four blocks.
Okay, I've got four blocks, so I need one more block. I need eight more blocks. That doesn't make any sense. Why do I need eight more blocks?
No, you need eight blocks altogether.
Altogether, I see.
So right here, you move forward.
Okay.
You bring this down here.
All right.
And you bring this down here.
Okay.
You like it down here.
Okay. And do I bring this last one down?
No. You bring this.
This one?
Down here.
Is Elsa?
That is Elsa.
Yeah, Elsa, you just made her.
Nice job.
So right here, this basically shows you the code in JavaScript, and it tells you that universities also use this code, such as Berkeley and Harvard. And if you have time, I'd like to show you how to use it in JavaScript.
Okay.
So right here, this is basically the same thing, it's just in JavaScript. So
okay.
You want to write
so
a code.
I would actually type up. So yeah. I could type, for example.
You gotta break move and then make the F capital.
So I gotta make the F the higher case.
Mm-hmm.
Move. Oops.
Yeah.
And do I put like 100? Oh, what happened? What did I do?
You just go, you just put it.
Alright.
And you gotta put the comma. And 100. And
close. Semicolon.
Mm-hmm. And now when you press 1, you're going to.
See, same
thing.
Alright, I'm going to look at this one.
We have a coding president.
I do. Now, how long have you guys been working on this?
Coder in chief.
Yeah, coder in chief.
When did you guys get down here?
We got it down here yesterday.
Yesterday?
Yeah.
So had any of you done coding before?
Well, we did it once in class.
Once in class. And then, so is this pretty interesting, the idea that you might be able to code and make up your own games and things like that? Well, that's pretty cool. Absolutely. And it turns out that the concepts are not that complicated, right? Have you had a chance to get a sense of how this connects to the work you do, like a math class and stuff? Megan, the basic concept behind coding is that you take zeros and ones, you take two numbers, that those can
yes
be
or no.
Yes or no. Those can be translated into electrical messages that then run through the computer. Right?
So it's just a list of instructions. So you just create a list of instructions to make Elsa dance around and do the square.
Right.
So it's just a list of instructions.
Right. So it's all it's doing is it's saying yes or no over and over again. And the computer's powerful enough that it can read a really long set of instructions really quickly.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah, these days the ones and zeros, nobody even thinks about them.
Right.
You just give the computer the commands and they're much closer to English. You say, do this, do that, do this, and the computer does what you want.
Because we have the baseline language that you've established.
Yeah, there's so many, the language people are using, this drag and drop stuff, under the hood there's many levels of more complicated, harder things that you don't need to think about.
One of the things we wanted to highlight today is that right after World War II, there was a very incredible American, Grace Hopper, Rear Admiral Grace Hopper, and we brought some things from the Navy archive to share. But she was the first person to start taking it out of sort of that machine code and use a human language, an English-like language, and create what's called a compiler that crunches it down into that language. And so we're celebrating Grace Hopper because her birthday would have been tomorrow.
Well, the point is, a lot of times, people don't realize that women were deeply involved in doing some, a lot of this stuff. So sometimes girls, you guys aren't always participating as much in math class as science class. But it turns out that some of the folks who really helped to make computers work the way they do today were women. Now, they weren't always being paid the same, and they were sometimes wanting to give them credit. They were doing the work, and then some guy was giving credit. But that's, we got to change that. We got to make sure that we got a lot of young women. We got to make sure that African Americans and minorities, that we're involved in this stuff, because this is the future right here. So I expect you guys to be doing some coding someday. Alright? You gonna stay with us? Alright. Pete, you got a picture of my crew here?
You wanna maybe
I'm gonna swing around here.
Watch you guys stand up.
Come on guys. Come on over here. Come on. You guys can stay seated. By the way, did the hat mess up my hair a little bit? Still okay?
How are you? You
got a nice shirt. Thank you, guys. Appreciate you. All right, good job.
Just go visit us. Okay, so these guys are doing the seminar, right?
What's your name?